Booker and Warren on the perimeter. Bender out there with Mirza Teletovic. And it's Baller in at the one spot. Who's out there for Phoenix. Basket good. And Chris, you had a great and very long playing career. Talk about how that's prepared you for broadcasting.
I think it's prepared me for broadcasting. Talk about something that we love, man, and you make me look great. It's easy, man, working with great teammates. You know that great teammates make you better, and you're the best point guard in the business the way you throw the assist out there. So yeah, I've been fortunate to have great experience with great teammates.
Yeah, you sound great. It's an honor to work with you, but I always like
shooting from Phoenix.
You always give me an answer that sometimes I don't expect. I think
watch the games, and I've seen some great guys. George Blaha from Detroit, I grew up watching him. And I just love just the pure honesty of what you're thinking at that moment. And don't take it personal, because I love the game, and so I don't want to have to try to protect a thought or an old school or a group of people. If a guy plays bad, he's the best in the world, I'm going to say it. And if he made a move I've never seen, I'm just really going to say it. And so I try not to exaggerate and just say specifically how I feel. And I'm glad to be a part of the game after feeling so much emotion. It's easy just being yourself.
Now here's Peyton. Following the miss shot by De'Aaron Fox. Trains it from beyond the arc.
At the defensive end, they've lost some of their focus since halftime.
Shot's good.
Tough shot. He's shooting one close to the bucket.
The Suns have made 5 of 8 of their free throw attempts.
And typically, a strength of theirs, 79% on the season.
Chris, you had some amazing years with the Kings. Thinking back on it, what was one of your favorite moments in this jersey?
Wow. Clinching the West in 2002. Really thought that was going to be our year. Half my jersey retired by the team. It was pretty special as well. And, you know, just the fans. Buckets in front of those fans, it's nothing like it. And so, just the memories I have being part of the community of Sacramento.
Now, here's Green, currently averaging almost 6 points a game. Johnson the screen. Hayward goes in. Can't hit from in close.
They haven't been able to count his scoring tonight, but still, here they are in the lead.
The pass to Warren. Teletovic the screen. Over in the corner, Bender. It's going to be out of bounds. The Suns will retain possession.
Phoenix call.
And the Suns call Phoenix time here. They're moving on after the tough loss they took at the hand playing. Which other power forwards did you just dread, just did not like going up against?
Well, Kevin, I would kind of change that and say dread to me is love, meaning that I dreaded and I love to go up against Tim Duncan, because you knew you had to be prepared that night. I love and I dreaded going up against KG. Tim Duncan, Hakeem Olajuwon, this is all on the West Coast, so for me, you know, I dreaded the Western Conference, but was so good about it that you just have to be prepared, and you can't dread the NBA. It's like you grew up wanting to play against the best players in life, and so I really love the fact that I had to be my best every night, or you're going to get embarrassed in the league, so it was every power forward.
Never an off night, was there, Chris?
Never an off night, and, you know, so I can't say I dreaded Karl Malone over Barkley or wet pants on, get ready and go to work, baby. Put your hard hat on.
Guys, this is where their depth really comes into play. They've got such talent at that position. They'd love to have him out there, but they won't suffer much of a drop-off.
The Kings making a switch here. Walker's checked in. Now, here's Hulis. He's got seven. Kings foul. Walker.
That's his first personal foul.
You really got to be in awe. That's the way that Kentavious Caldwell Pope plays defense. So disciplined in this era of three-point shooting to kind of stay home on fakes and playing great position
take a break.
Defense.
Take a break.
He just sticks to his
shots.
Man like glue.
And he makes the first. Al Caldwell Pope. It's not like he's playing defense on just anyone. Greg, he usually drives the opposing team's top scorer as his nightly assignment.
Yeah, and he's earned that responsibility because of his play. I mean, typically plays a ton of minutes and never slows down during the game. All around fantastic defensively.
Now, here's Fox. 26 points for him. Pass to Kufis. Knocks down the 10-footer. Kufis has got his second bucket of the game to go.
And in the first half, it was a struggle offensively, shooting a very low percentage, but it hasn't prevented them from grabbing the lead, and now they're shooting it much better here in the second. And another miss. He's having a really ugly game.
Yeah, about as ugly as you can have, you're right. Dishes it to Fox. Caldwell Pope brings the double team. Fox passes to Hayward. And a wide open look for Walker. The basket good off the assist for Hayward. Hayward's got three assists in the game. Phoenix has gotten blank from three-point land so far in the third. Still 0-for-3. Hulis kicks to Chris. Back to Hulis. Now, here's Warren. He's got 13. And the Suns miss again.
Yeah, and they've shown effort and aggression in the paint, really, right from the top. Their rebound is right now massive.
At the end of the league, they need to put on more weight. They need to build up a little bit. And how aggressive saying that were you looking to add strength when you came into the NBA?
Well, I was fortunate that I already had an NBA-type body, so I really didn't need to try to bulk up for the NBA. You know, I really disagree that a lot of guys got to get stronger. Look at Kevin Durant. You know, we all know the famous story about how trainers laughed at him when he got to the league. Do you have skill? Can you play? So, no, Curry doesn't need to put on 25 pounds of muscle, I think we've seen. Durant doesn't need to put on 15 pounds of muscle. It's more about your game. It's more about your core and your balance. You'll pick up natural weight and natural strength as you go along. But how is your work ethic? Are you in the gym? Are you lifting? Are you working out? Are you getting stronger? That's great. But you don't have to necessarily try to get stronger. Just try to make sure you have game. That's most important. But it looked as if he would never find his game after that awful first half start. But he has really hit this stride in the second half.
Here's Green to the left wing. Phoenix takes possession.
I think he was surprised to see that pass coming his way and just really reacted too late.
Phoenix has gotten just 1 of 4 three-pointers to go down for them here in the fourth. Now, here's Hulis, guarded by Fox. Second-chance shot, and the layup is good.
To give up those second-chance points.
It could be discouraging, frustrating, but you only have yourselves to blame. Fox out.
The kick out to Walker, and there's the foul. We'll go on Mo Harkless. That's foul number 2 for him. And you look at the level of talent in the NBA now, some great players. But we've heard others say the league is watered down. How do you view that?
Well, I don't think you can compare eras. I think it's great to argue and have fun with them and debate them. But, you know, very sincerely, unless someone can play against each other, it's just a wasted argument. It's different eras, there's different rules. Think about how many threes Larry Bird shot per game. 1.5, 2. What if he could let it fly 10 times a game? We'd be talking about a different player there. So I think of the 80s, of the 90s, I just know that players were handling it differently. Hand checking, the way that we call flagrant 1 foul. This is a different league, and so I just choose to celebrate the players that we have now. They're the evolution. In my mind, they're kind of a combination of all the players that have come before them, so I just enjoy the game the way it is now.
Brown, he's checked in for the Suns. Now Phoenix shooting fairly well before the fourth, around 48%. Ewing sets the screen for Brown. There's a minute 34 left here in the fourth quarter. Sacramento's gone 0-3 so far in the fourth quarter from long range.
And one team is just completely outclassing the other tonight. Spirited performance, and it really ignited what is turning out to be a monster win here for Sacramento.
As one-sided as it gets today, you know, there were some down moments in about every facet of this game for that team.
Yeah, I mean, Kevin, it's hard to think of what didn't go right for them. Game planning by the coaches, execution by the players, everything was just on target.
And so this is going to end up as victory number 24 on the year.
And with this win, they bring the season series to an end, guys, with a split, two games apiece.
And one of the key components of this victory, if not the biggest, was the incredible performance for De'Aaron Fox.
Every time he shot it, it seemed like it was going to drop in. And if it didn't, everyone was surprised.
And stolen by Chris. And up the court come the Suns on the break. Floats one up. So there was a close on the shot for two free throws for the contact right there. First free throw is good. The Suns making a change here. Powell's checked in. That one falls, so he hits both of them. Here's Fox. 36 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. It's Bogdanovich on the wing. Heartless with the steal. It's blocked. 20 seconds left to play in the final quarter. Fox kicks to Bogdanovich. The long distance three is buried.
And how much longer are they going to keep that foot on the accelerator?
At this point, it's just icing on the cake. Terrific run closes it out.
So it's the Kings winning this one easily. A resounding victory for them. And bring an enemy territory, Nolan.
That's exactly right. But with the way they controlled the game and just completely took the crowd out of it, that's how to get it done on the road.
And that'll do it, folks. For Greg Anthony, Chris Webber, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Hart.
Are you kidding me?
The NBA, presented by 2K Sports.
Babies.